Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Saratoga Racecourse here on Wednesday. It is August 22nd, 2018. I'm going to look at races 1 and 9 from the spot, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. So let's get on to it. We're going to look at races 1 and 9. The first race, it's over the jumps. It's the Michael G. Walsh Novice Chase. It's going for a purse of $75,000. Races for 4-year-olds and upwards. Never won over the hurdles prior to March the 1st of 2017, which never won through races here. Field of 7 horses going the distance of ground of 3,800 meters or the distance of ground of 2 miles and 3/8 on the inner turf course, which is the jumps course. 3,800 meters, 2 miles, 3/8. So it's a very fun long jump race. My top selection, I'm going to go to the 2 horse here, Salix. I'm going to go 2-6-3-4 in the superfecta. 2-6-3-4 super. Top selection, 2 horse, Salix. First time Lasix. First start stateside. Gerard Gilligan's on this one, or Galligan. This horse is most recent outing. Came the 6th of June. I came at Utoxeter in the UK. 2.5 miles and just a class 4 handicap. He did everything right there. He won by 8 lengths. He was stepping down from his last run. And, you know, he jumped well and just had a very good race there. Before that, Huntington, the 28th of May. 2.9 miles in a handicap, class 3. He won by 9 lengths there. Again, he was the 4-1 favorite. He jumped well, and, you know, he had the race down by the last few hurdles. Good race for this horse there. And then before that, Tauster, a mile 11.16, which is a mile 7.5 furlongs, shall I say, in a handicap. This horse finished 4th by 1.25 lengths and never really got into it. Didn't jump that well. Lacked a little on the run, and it wasn't the day to win. But his last two are very nice. I expect him to run a big one here today, and, you know, watch out for him. I did back this horse a few times, I believe, in the UK this winter, you know, but those were the races where he ran shit. You know, he finished 6th by 40.5 lengths. That's where I remember backing him at Hereford, and then I remember backing him at Kempton right after Christmas, and that's where he got beat by 86 lengths. But, you know, I think here on the stateside, these races are nearly as tough, and I just think I'll run a big one at 8-1. Take my chance with them, so watch out. Just one thing off subject here. Before December of 2017, he was running over the flat, and he had a race in, and he was previously running in France. He had a race at Pontichon last November where he won, going 1.5 miles in a maiden special weight. He won by 1.75 lengths and was 106-1 at post time, which is just pretty impressive. And he had a great turn of foot there. I watched the replay, but you don't see a lot of 106-1 shots, you know, in winning. But that was quite cool. Didn't happen that day, but don't even remember the race. But he should run well here today, so watch out. So to recap my selections for the first from Saratoga, it's the Michael G. Walsh Novice. Gonna go with the 2-horse Alex. Gonna go 2-6-3-4 in the superfecta. To race number 9, which is probably my favorite race of the Saratoga meeting, one of my favorite races, shall we say. It's my favorite. If you watch the Howard Stern show or listen to the Howard Stern show, you know who says that. You can't have more than one favorite, I know, but I do. But the 9th race, it's one of my favorites. It's the John's Call Stakes, purse $100,000, which for 3-year-olds and upwards, never won a graded sweepstakes in 2018. A very good field of 16 horses. The 13 through 16 are main track only, so only 12 will go on the turf course, distance of ground of 2,600 meters, if you want to go with that, or the distance of ground of 1.58 miles on the Mellon turf course, 2,600 meters, 1.58 miles. And this is probably two of the longest races of the, you know, the first and the, both these races I'm looking at Saratoga are probably the longest races of the summer here. So, you know, quite fun. But if this race does get taken off turf and it's going to be run on the main track, it's only going to be run at 1.25 miles. So you're going to lose about 0.5 miles of the race, which is, kind of annoying, but it's going to be a different race if it's run on dirt, and I think if that happens, the main track onlys here, all 4 of them look like they all have strong chances here, and a lot of the turf horses don't really have a lot of dirt form, so I think it's going to be down to the, if this race would be on the main track and taken off the turf, I think the main track onlys have it. It's just which one, but hopefully this race stays on the turf, because my top selection I like a lot, and that's going to be the number 9 horse here, Rocketry. I'm going to go 9-10-2-5 in the superfecta, 9-10 2.5 Super, Top Selection 9 Horse Rocketry, 4-year-old Colt by Hardspun, Jibby Jerkins trains, Johnny Velasquez is on this one. This horse's most recent appearance came 21st of July at Saratoga. Mile 3 rates in a turf course, obsolete claimer. This horse finished third by half length there. A little bit wide, but he had a little bit of a turn of foot at the end. It wasn't a bad race. A lot of horses from that race are coming back to run in this one today, so good local prep race, I guess. Before that, another race a lot of horses are coming out of came at Belmont, 2 miles the 8th of June in the Belmont Gold Cup. This horse finished fourth by 2 lengths there. Nobody was catching Call to Mind that day, who ran a hell of a race. This horse, you know, a little bit of turn of foot, but wasn't the day to win. Call to Mind actually, in the next start, actually got injured, and now he's sadly retired, but he had a great run there, winning for the Queen of England. And then before that, this horse ran the 27th of April at Belmont, mile and a quarter in a turf course off 6-2 claimer. Horse won by 3 lengths, sat back early, but had a great turn of foot on a race course that does not play towards closers. Got there in the end and took off clear. You know, he hasn't run this distance before, but there's no doubt in my mind he can, he could definitely get the distance of ground. He likes this turf course. His last one was very good here. I think he's going to run a big one, so watch out for him if this race stays on turf. Now, if it's run on the dirt, I don't want to be near this horse at all, because he has no dirt for him. But, watch out for him on turf. And I think another horse, Call Provision, the 10 horse, could get a piece of it. He'll be a horse I'll use on the multi-race if this race stays on the turf. 10 horse, Call Provision. Irad Ortiz Jr. is on this one for Chad Brown. His horse's most appearance came in the that Saratoga race, mile 3 rates optional lady claimer on the 21st of July. This horse won that race by a neck, and he sat towards the inside that day, but he had a decent turn of foot, just getting up there in the nick of time. Good victory for this horse there. Before that, 24th of June at Belmont, mile 3 rates inner turf course optional lady claimer. Horse finished second by a neck. A little bit of a trouble trip, but he had a little bit of a turn of foot at the end. The winner, Highland Sky, just ran a little bit better race, but he ran okay there. And then the Man of War, he finished fourth. It just wasn't the day to win. The ground was a little bit wetter than probably he wanted. He never got the good closing kick. But this is, again, another horse that should definitely get the distance of ground. You know, if you save some ground, I think he could, get a piece of it. So he'll be used on the multi. But to recap my selections now for the ninth from the spa, it's the John's Call Stakes. Going to go as a top selection, a 9-horse Rocketry. Going to go 9-10-2-5 in the Superfecta. I'll go 9-10 in the multi-race if this race is on the turf. Now, if this race is run on the dirt, like I said, the main track onlys in this race are the horses you want. All four of them I would use in a multi-race instantly if this race is run on the dirt. But hopefully that doesn't happen. But good luck to all. And please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. And join me this Saturday for my Traverse preview video. Good luck, everybody.